Hey, y'all. Was on a road trip for the last few days. Came home today and was driving back by myself with no conversation going on in the car. So I was just listening to the music and really hearing it. Which, actually, unfortunately, I don't get the chance to do as often these days. But as I'm listening to The Who, Magic Bus came on. And, you know, on YouTube there are 1,000 people, including PT, who have posted this one. And I would suspect that virtually everyone, including PT, would have played something like this. So the guitar is tuned down about half a step, so your low E is this. And it would be played with A to G to D. In fact, let's play just a little bit of it and you can see what I'm talking about. That would be your first guess. If you don't listen, you know, really critically, that's what you'd hear. And that's what I've heard for many, many years. Probably 40 years. But there's something wrong with that, and here's what it is. For starters, if you were going to play it like that, and if you can watch videos of The Who playing it, even in the Keith Moon years, there's that one clip of them on French TV, and Pete's clearly doing it with A, and then G suspended, and then D. I would play instead of the G like that. I would play it like that, with the C note, be it the first fret. And that's how it sounds, and that's what it looks like. In fact, if you watch live videos, even up to the present day, Pete, in his solo versions that he does, and in the band versions, he's playing with A, G, D. That's what he does. So that's what you'd assume, but check this out. It's not an exaggeration to say this blew my mind when I really listened to it, because I just thought it was that all these years, you know. But I'm thinking it's this. Now, I took this guitar, tuned it to the same as that one. So this was tuned down a half a step, then I put the capo on. So if this were in standard, you know, concert pitch, the capo would be, well, let's see if this would be tuned up a little higher. Yeah, the capo would be here instead, one fret down. But wherever the capo goes, I believe there's a capo. So you can hear one thing pretty clearly in a bunch of different spots, and that is... You hear that over and over again on the third fret from the capo, on the high E to the second fret, to that. Now, there's a couple of things about that. One, you would expect that if it were just doing exactly the same thing as what that other guitar sounded like, it would be D, A. But it's not. It's E, G, D. And if that sounds familiar, E to G to D. That's because it shows up in other places in Pete's songwriting. The one that comes to mind right off the top of my head is Who Are You? That stuff. But there are a couple of things that make this version make a little bit more sense. And one of them is the guitar solo. That sounds a lot closer to it that this part. That just sounds like a ringing open string rather than a fretted string. So I think it's actually this. Or the one guitar is doing this. There might be two guitars, one without a capo like that other one, and one with like this. So I'm going to try going through it on this one. So the chords now would be E. That's G. To D. G5, actually. Go. Just pretend this is in tune. So I'm going to run through this. I'll probably change this because I haven't heard it and actually studied the structure of it. When does it go to this break? And all that. In a while, but tell me if you think you're hearing what I'm hearing. What's going on? At least on one of the guitars. So I don't know if there are other people on YouTube playing it like this. I doubt it, because probably everybody's been listening to it the same way I have all this time. Not really paying that close attention to it. But I think there are a couple of guitars and one of them's capoed. So. Give it a listen and see what you think of that, and let me know in the comments what you think. Good luck.